So you know that to start a note, you're using your tongue, kind of a little explosion of air, like right? Well, the tongue is not used to stop the sound, not always. I'd say 99% of the time, you don't use your tongue to stop the note. Now, if you're not used to this, here, let me give you an example. So this time I'm going to stop the note with my tongue, like tut, tut, tut. Can you hear how the end of the note just abruptly shuts off? Well, that's not what you want. What you do want is a nice gradual end to the note. So let me do that G again, but this time I'm just going to stop my air and not use my tongue. Okay, it's got a nice shape to it, right? Now, if you're not used to doing that, you might get something that sounds like this. Okay, see how it kind of dives off at the end? You don't want that. What causes that is not keeping your embouchure and your air steady at the end of the note. So basically everything is frozen in place, nice and solid with your pitch, and then you just stop the air, but stop the air quickly. Okay, like you're stopping with your tongue quickly, but just use your air, just stop the air. So if this is new to you, if you're having trouble ending notes cleanly and clearly and beautifully, then this is a great thing to do as a warm-up. It's a great thing to do as a warm-up anyway, just to do low, slow notes with nice space in between each note so you can just kind of get into that flow of what it feels like to end a note correctly. So when I'm doing this, usually I'll start on a G and go down to a C, maybe a little lower to a B-flat or so. It's kind of boring, so I don't do it a whole lot, but it is a nice, easy, relaxed way to warm up the tongue and to get yourself thinking about how to end notes. So I hope this helped you. Have fun. Good luck with your practice.